Hello everyone, this is Dipto from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my new video. In today's video, I'm going to talk about a new feature which is coming up along with Winter 24 release. With this feature, you can now create your custom error message and display that in your record trigger flow. So without any further delay, let's jump to our Salesforce org and see this with an example. So here I am in my Salesforce org. What I have done, I have created an opportunity validation rule. And the opportunity validation rule is like when you are creating an opportunity, there has to be something in the description field in the opportunity record. Then this is my use case. I'm creating a new case. Let's say, let's put some information here. And this case belongs to this case origin phone, priority medium, and subject as laptop not working, description. I'll keep the description as blank. And then I'm creating the case record. Now in the case record, there is a custom checkbox field, which is convert to opportunity. Once I check on this checkbox, there is a record triggered flow on the case, which basically convert this case to an opportunity. So here is the flow. This is a record triggered flow, which runs on case object every time a record is created or updated with the convert to opportunity, which is basically this checkbox. Convert to opportunity becomes true. And then what it's doing, it's actually creating an opportunity record, mapping few information like the case account ID goes to the opportunity account ID, current date as a close date, description goes to the opportunity description, subject goes to the opportunity name, and stage name, I'm defaulting to prospecting. So this is the flow. Now, and also I have this opportunity validation rule. Now, when I try to click on this checkbox and the record trigger flow will execute, it will try to convert this case to an opportunity, right? But since there is no description in the case record, so the new opportunity that will be created, there will also be nothing in the description field, right? But that's the validation rule violation. Validation rule will not allow me to create an opportunity if the description field is blank. So let's see that how it will show. So now I'm clicking on this checkbox and click on save. My record triggered flow executed and it gave me this error. And this is an error we all know, right? This is an error we have already seen number of times. It's a Salesforce standard error message. So what this Winter 24 is giving you the option to replace this error with your custom error message. So for that, this is error message field custom validation. So let me copy that. And now I'll come back to this flow. The first thing that I'll do, I'll put a fault path. And in the fault path, I will go for a decision. And decision I need because there can be multiple validation rules, multiple errors, right? Depending on the what type of error, if I can catch that, I can have my own custom error message accordingly, right? So this is what it's doing. Check error message. And then this is error message. How I can check? So in the flow, there is a variable called fault message and contents. This is the message. This is a message which I'm getting from the validation rule. Description cannot be blank. So I put that here. Opportunity description cannot be blank. That's error message. Opportunity description cannot be blank. Done. Once this is here, and now when I click on this plus sign, this is a new element which comes with Winter 24. So you'll find an option called custom error. So click on that and let's give a name, show error message. And then here you can put your own error message and you can also choose where you want to show the error message. You want to show the error message on the record page or under some field, right? You can basically select the field. For example, you can select description field, right? Or you can select it's on the record page. So now do that and then click on save. And then click on activate. Now I'll go back to the same case record. And this time when I click on the convert to opportunity, this is the error message I'm getting. Instead of the previous long Salesforce error message, now I have an option to customize my error message and show the error message based on my requirement. Now this error message is shown on the record page. I can also make this to show under the description, right? If I choose description field and then save as and then activate. Now again, I'll go back to the case record and convert to opportunity and then save. Now this time, opportunity description cannot be blank. So it's coming under the description field. So this is a new feature which is coming up with Winter 24 release. And with that feature, as you can see, you can have your own custom message to show depending on what is causing the problem, what is causing your flow to fail. So now let's see another example. Oh, let's say, let's correct this case and put some description. So I'm copying the subject to the description field. And now if I click on convert to opportunity, my flow will run and it will create and it will convert this case to an opportunity. A new opportunity will be created. So now if I click here, I can see there is a new opportunity created. If I go to the details section, everything looks good. I can see this is the opportunity name. This is account. I can see the description looks good. And also the case number, right? This is important. From which case this opportunity is created. So case number is 1033, which is basically this case. Now, let's see one more example. The example is now, let's say I have another opportunity validation rule. And the validation rule is like this. Validation rule is you cannot delete an opportunity when the opportunity stage is closed on. So basically in the opportunity field, there is a checkbox set to delete. So you cannot mark an opportunity. You cannot check this checkbox true when the opportunity stage is closed on. So how we can do that? So let's see that in example. So for that, I have created one more flow. So let me go to that flow. And this time is basically that flow will run when I will delete the case. So basically this is my use case. When I'll delete a case, the flow will run on record deletion and it will find out any associated opportunity with that case. And in those opportunities, set that checkbox to true. But if the associated opportunity is in closed one stage, then I have an opportunity validation rule which will not allow me to set this checkbox to true. So let's go to the flow. It will be a record triggered flow on the case delete trigger. So it's a big flow, but let me explain you what this flow is doing. So first, the case that this flow is record triggered flow, which runs on the case object when a case record is deleted. What is doing here? It's actually trying to find all the related opportunity and then find all the related opportunities and then set to delete. This is a particular field on the opportunity record, which is basically this field set to delete. It's trying to make that field value as true. Now we know that there is already a validation rule which will not allow me to set this field to delete because my opportunity is in a closed one stage. So if that will happen, this is the error message that will come up, right? So what I'm doing on this one, I've created a fault path and then a check, which is basically checking the fault message again, and fault message contains cannot delete a closed one opportunity, and then display that error message here, right? So first thing I'll do, I'll mark this opportunity as closed one. Save. And now if I go and delete this case, I will get an error message that you cannot delete a closed one opportunity. And this error message is coming from here. This error message is basically this error message. In the previous example, we saw that it can show an error message when things are happening on the same object. But here we saw when things are happening on some other related object, then also you can show the error message. Let's see one more example, okay? So I've created an opportunity trigger. So let's open the opportunity trigger. Really what this trigger is doing is this trigger is running on before delete and then showing an error message that opportunity cannot be deleted. So now, let me change this opportunity stage to something else like the qualification, right? Okay, since my opportunity is qualification, now if I try to delete this case, case delete trigger will run and it will come to this note. But this time, what this is trying to do, it will try to mark this field as true on the opportunity record, and it will be successful because the validation rule only works if the opportunity stage is closed down. But now my opportunity is in qualification, so it will work and it will mark this opportunity as delete, set to delete as checked, right? Then what is the second node doing? Second node is basically trying to delete that record, delete all the opportunities, right? But this time it will fail not because of any validation rule, but it will fail because of my trigger. My trigger is not allowing me to delete any opportunity. And this is the error message that I will be getting from the trigger. And I can capture that error message inside flow and show that in my UI, right? So what I'm doing on this delete, I'm creating again a fault path. And here is my decision element where the fault message contains this message, basically the message I configured inside my trigger. And then if this is the message, then I have to show that error message in the UI. And this is my UI, opportunity cannot be deleted. So let's see that. So now let's delete this case. So if I try to go and delete the case, I'm getting an error message that opportunity cannot be deleted because the error message is coming from my trigger that opportunity cannot be deleted. I'm capturing that error message inside my flow here and then presenting my own custom error message. Now, if I refresh this page, opportunity, I can see that set to delete is also not checked. Even though this node should already update that field to true, but this node failed, so automatically the rollback happened. And that is why whatever DML operation happened at this node is already rolled back. So this is a very powerful feature which is coming up with Winter 24 release. So now basically you can capture your error message which causes your flow to fail. And that message or that failure can come from a validation rule. It can come from a trigger. It can come from any processes, right? As long as you can capture that message inside your flow, you can now present your own custom message to the user, right? Instead of user seeing that, you know, Salesforce standard error message, you can guide user that, okay, something is wrong in that record, so you better fix that and then try this, right? For example, as we see, when we are trying to convert the case to the opportunity, the process failed, the flow failed. But if we can present the error message that, you know, guys, you need to go and put some value in the case description field, that is what is needed to convert this case to an opportunity. So with this new feature, now it will be very easy for admins and developers to create a flow and write their own custom error message, which can be presented to the user. And by doing that, it will be much easier for the user also to understand what is wrong in the record and fix that to make the process success or make the transaction success. So that's all. I hope this video is helpful. Please hit the like icon, share, and please subscribe to my channel so that you can get update about all my upcoming videos. In next couple of days, I'll be publishing more videos covering new features which are coming up with Winter 24 release. So it's important that you subscribe to my channel so that you are the first person to see or not get notified when I'll publish new content. Till then, thank you. Bye-bye.